Conscious International Media Conference Call. My name is Jenny, and I'll be your operator for today's call. At this time, all participants are in a listen-only mode. Later, we will conduct a question-and-answer session. During the question-and-answer session, if you have a question, please press star, then 1 on your touch-tone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I will now turn the call over to Roberto Diaz. Mr. Diaz, you may begin.
Thank you very much. Thank you to all the media that dialed in today for the Canelo versus Golovkin Trainers International Media Conference Call. With Canelo's trainer, Eddie Reynoso, and Gennady Golovkin, Triple G's trainer, Abel Sanchez. The middleweight battle for supremacy between lineal and ring middleweight champion, world champion Canelo Alvarez, and WBC, IBO, IBF, and WBA middleweight world champion Gennady Triple G Golovkin. It's Saturday, September 16th at the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas and will be televised by the best network, the Network of Champions, HBO pay-per-view. Today we will hear from both trainers on how their fighters are preparing for the biggest fight of their careers with an opportunity to ask some questions. I want to take a moment to thank our sponsors, Tecate, Born Bold, Hennessy, Never Stop, Never Settle, O'Reilly Auto Parts, and Fred Loya Insurance. Interjet, Phantom Events, Tessena Bank, and Capital Holdings. I also want to remind everyone to mark their calendars for the episode number 1 of 24/7, Canelo Golovkin, which premieres Saturday, August 26th, on HBO, immediately following the Koto Kamagai Live World Championship Boxing Doubleheader from the StubHub Center. Lastly, don't forget that while tickets for the T-Mobile are sold out, there's still tickets for closed circuit at the Bellagio Resort and Casino, MGM Grand Hotel Casino, Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino, the Mirage Hotel and Casino, Monte Carlo Resort and Casino, New York Hotel and Casino, Luxor Hotel and Casino, and the Circus Las Vegas. They're priced at $75, not including any applicable fees. All seats are general admission and are currently on sale. Tickets may be purchased at any MGM International box office by phone with a major credit card at 1-800-745-3000 or online at www.ticketmaster.com. I'd like to hand it over to our co-promoter, Tom Loeffler, with Triple G Promotions to make some brief comments and introduce Gennady Golovkin's trainer, Mr. Abel Sanchez. Tom?
Thanks, Robert. We couldn't be more excited about this event coming up. You can't describe it other than it's the biggest event in boxing. We've gotten a tremendous response since both of these warriors agreed to fight each other September 16th. It's been everything's gone smooth working together with Golden Boy. I've been up to the camp a number of times. We've never gotten so many media requests to come up to the summit gym up in Big Bear where Abel Sanchez does all the training, and it's just the flood of requests is amazing. You always have to balance it between accommodating the media requests and Gennady actually preparing for the fight. So with that being said, I want to introduce the two-time trainer of the year, Abel Sanchez.
Abel, you want to just make a few opening comments?
Pardon me, Abel has dropped. I will dial out.
So let me introduce to you guys one of the best trainers while we get Abel back on the line. Let's hear just opening comments from one of the best trainers in the business today, Eddie Reynoso, who's preparing Canelo for his showdown with Gennady Golovkin. Eddie, unas palabras, por favor.
Hola, buenos días. Aquí estamos para servirles. Saludos a todos.
I just want to say hello to everybody. Good morning, and we're here to serve you. Let us know when we get Abel back on.
Maybe if you want, Robert, we can already start, if you want, with a couple of questions for... it says...
Yeah, it'll be questions for both, but I mean, I can't agree more. I mean, look, like Tom said, it's the fight that all the fans, all the media, everybody's been asking for. It's here, just a few weeks away, and this is a fight you definitely don't want to miss. It could go down as one of the best middleweight fights in history. We have Abel?
He says he's dialing back in. He says he can hear us, but apparently there's some problem with him. So I just told him to dial back in, so he should be dialing in right now.
Well, if we could give him a couple seconds, see, and then we'll get an introduction, and if not, then we can open it up to the media.
Okay.
Operator?
Yes.
Any luck there?
I see him now. One moment.
Okay, good. Tom, you'll introduce him then?
Yeah, as soon as he's back on. Or we can just go straight into...
Open
he said he heard everything.
Yeah. Okay.
You can just go straight into Abel and talk.
Sanchez is on.
Abel, do you want to say a few words about how the training is going up there in Big Bear, and then we can just open it up for questions for you and Eddie?
Sure, Tom. Thank you, Robert, for the intro. Buenos dias, Eddie. Good morning to everybody online, all the media. Training is going great. We're really looking forward to September 16th. I think that the two best fighters in boxing are going to meet each other that night. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Abel. Thank you. Operator, we're ready to open it up.
Thank you. We will now begin the question and answer session. If you have a question, please press star then one on your touch-tone phone. If you're using a speakerphone, you may need to pick up the handset first before pressing the numbers. Once again, if you have a question, please press star then one on your touch-tone phone. And our first question is from Dan Raphael from ESPN.
Hello, everybody. I had a couple questions. Abel, glad you were able to make it to the call. Looked a little dicey there for a second, but here's my question for you, and I'll get Eddie's take on this in a minute. Obviously, the competition is between Gennady Golovkin and Canelo Alvarez, but I know that trainers are competitive also and certainly want to win for their own careers, obviously for their fighters' careers. So I wanted to know from your perspective, like, when you say it's the two best fighters in boxing in a big, big fight that we have on September 16th, how do you look at it in terms of the competition between yourself and your opposing trainer, Eddie Reynoso?
I think at this point, if you consider those two fighters the best fighters in boxing, I think these are the two best trainers in boxing also. Eddie and Chepo have done a fantastic job with Canelo, and I think that we've done a great job with Gennady. The winner on the 16th is not necessarily the best fighter in boxing, but the best fighter that night. Same with the trainers. I think that that competition between us needs to be that so that we can prepare our guys to be the best they can be that night.
Can you also tell me, we've seen Gennady knock out so many opponents. Obviously, he didn't get the knockout in the fight with Danny in March, but he had a 23 knockout streak before that. But Canelo has had some spectacular knockouts himself in his recent fights, not necessarily the Chavez fight, but in some fights prior to that. So both guys are looked at as punchers in this fight. They're both obviously very good boxers. When you look at the matchup, do you think this is more of a fight where Gennady is going to be the guy to be the biggest puncher, or is he the one that's going to have to get the win to outbox Canelo Alvarez? How do you view that aspect of this matchup?
No, I see both guys being aggressive, and I see Gennady being more physical. I see Gennady trying to dictate the pace. Canelo has proven that he's a warrior. We're looking for a tough fight. I think that both guys are going to hurt each other. and they may go down. But I think it's going to be treated to a throwback fight like in the mid-'80s when the four kings, the five kings were around.
You say you might see Gennady get knocked down. In his entire professional career and his amateur career, there was no evidence of him being seriously hurt in a fight or even close to going down. Is that because you have that much respect for Canelo's punching power, or are you just trying to hype this up a little bit?
No, I have respect not only for his punching power, but I have respect for Eddie and Chepo doing the things that are necessary to counteract some of the things that we're going to be doing. I think it's a fight where it's going to be a chess match at the beginning, and then once they get past that point where they're trying to see what each other's doing, they're going to go at each other. And now it's going to be up to us in the corner to make sure that we dictate what we want done and make sure that we come up with a different plan if the first one's not working.
Thank you very much for that, Abel. I would like to ask Eddie. Robert, you're translating, I take it, for Eddie?
Yes, sir.
Could you ask him, similar to what I asked Abel as it related to the competition that exists between the trainers. Abel Sanchez was the 2015 Trainer of the Year, has got a lot of credit for the work he has done, not only with Gennady, but for some other fighters like Gassiev and that sort of thing. Eddie has never been the Trainer of the Year. I think a lot of people think the winner of this fight might be the Fighter of the Year. How big of a deal is it for Eddie to compete against another outstanding trainer like Abel Sanchez and maybe, you know, etch himself as a possible Trainer of the Year if his man gets the big victory?
Eddie, la pregunta para ti es, obviamente la pelea del 16 es entre Canelo y Golovkin, pero también pues hay una competencia, se puede decir, entre las esquinas, entre los entrenadores. Abel Sanchez ha sido reconocido como uno de los mejores entrenadores. En el 2015 le dieron premio del entrenador del año. A ti, pues, no te han dado esos premios, esos reconocimientos. ¿Crees que el vencedor de esta pelea podría ser hasta el peleador del año? ¿Es motivante, es un extra para ti ganar esta pelea también para que ya empiecen a dar reconocimiento a Eddie Reynoso como uno de los mejores entrenadores del mundo?
Buenas tardes. Pues, antes que nada, lo más importante para nosotros es que gane nuestro peleador. Nosotros sabemos que en el boxeo hay que ir caminando poco a poco. Creo que somos jóvenes, estamos en un muy buen nivel con nuestro boxeador. Hay que trabajar. Lo más importante, como te digo, es ganar esta pelea y pues los reconocimientos ya vendrán después. Lo que nos interesa es ganar, acomodar el lugar esta pelea y ya que pase lo que tenga que pasar.
Well, good afternoon to everybody. Thank you. Look, at the end of the day, the most important thing for us is that our fighter wins. And we're doing everything necessary. We're preparing so that happens come fight night. Look, at the end of the day, with the results come all the recognitions and everything else will come with it. But the most important thing for us is to win September 16th.
All right, very good. Thank you both. Appreciate your time.
And our next question comes from Diego Martinez from Reforma.
Hola, ¿cómo están? Buenas tardes a ambos. La pregunta es para los dos. ¿Qué opinión tienen, obviamente, en los últimos años se habló mucho de Roach, se habló mucho del papá de Mayweather, pero ahorita ustedes son la cara del boxeo como entrenadores? ¿Qué tan importante es esto, obviamente, que la sangre mexicana esté dando de qué hablar en esta pelea?
Hago la traducción. The question from Diego to both trainers, both Abel and Eddie, is, look, in the past, Freddie Roach, Mayweather Sr., they've all gotten the attention of the boxing world as some of the best trainers. But today, all eyes, all focus is on Eddie Reynoso and Abel Sanchez. How important is it, how motivating is it that you guys are the top trainers right now and all eyes are on you? Abel?
Well, first of all, I'm extremely proud that two Mexicans are guiding the two best fighters in the sport. And then we're going to be meeting each other for supremacy on the 16th. I'd be extremely happy that the fans recognize the fact that it's not only Canelo and Mexican, but Gennady fighting that Mexican style, but that Eddie and I are both very proud Mexicans.
La respuesta de Abel es que está muy orgulloso y muy contento que, pues obviamente es una pelea que tiene toda la atención del mundo, pero que dos mexicanos, tanto él como Eddie, están detrás de esta pelea, de que Con Golovkin también tienen un peleador que pelea al estilo mexicano, y pues obviamente con Canelo tienen a un mexicano. Entonces es muy importante para él. Eri, la misma pregunta para ti, papá.
Pues contento más que nada por el trabajo que se ha logrado y pues ir avanzando. Somos jóvenes, vamos empujando, nos gusta lo que hacemos, entonces hay que seguir por el mismo camino para el día de mañana pasado pues llegar a donde se pretende y estar dentro de los mejores en este deporte.
Now we're very, very happy, you know, to what we've achieved and happy doing what we love. And we got to keep advancing, keep doing what we do best, and that's winning and advancing, so that one day, hopefully not too in a distant future, we can be considered as one of the best in the game.
Gracias.
Gracias, Diego.
Once again, if you have a question, please press star then one on your touch-tone phone. And our next question comes from Rigo Cervantes from ESPN Digital.
¿Qué tal? Muy buenas tardes o buenos días, jóvenes. Tengo una pregunta para Eddie Reynoso. Eddie, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo le va? La pregunta que yo le haría es que cuando vino Golovkin a introducirse, a presentarse en el mercado de Estados Unidos, se anunció como un boxeador con estilo mexicano. Yo creo que tiene que ver con la influencia de Abel Sánchez. ¿Usted lo ve a Golovkin, Eddie, como un boxeador que tenga estilo mexicano de verdad?
So the question is for Eddie, when Triple G was introduced to mainstream, the American public, he was introduced with the label of Mexican style. And that could be with influence, obviously, of his trainer being Mexican, Abel Sanchez. But the question, Eddie, to Eddie Reynoso is, do you see him as a Mexican style fighter? Eddie, adelante.
Pues obviamente el estar entrenando con un mexicano, pues lo que le va a enseñar es el boxeo mexicano. Creo que ha aprendido algunas cosas del señor Abel, y de todos modos sus raíces son rusas, y el boxeo que trae él pues más ruso que mexicano. Sí ha adaptado algunas cosas que le han enseñado y pero de eso que diga que es totalmente un estilo mexicano, creo que no estoy yo de acuerdo. Sí tiene algunas cositas que las ha aprendido del señor Sánchez, pero no creo que sea un mero estilo mexicano.
Yeah, you know, it's obviously has some things of the Mexican style, because his trainer, there's influence there. He's taught him some Mexican style of fight, but let's not forget that at the end of the day, he's Russian, Kazakhstan. That's where his roots are. And although he may have a little bit of the Mexican style that he's been taught, at the end of the day, he can't have the full Mexican style.
¿Me permiten otra pregunta para el señor Abel Sánchez? Abel?
Adelante.
Sí, la pregunta que yo le hiciera a usted es, después de esta pelea el 16 de septiembre, ¿el ganador usted cree que debe ser considerado como el mejor libra por libra del mundo?
The question is to Mr. Abel Sanchez, is do you think that after September 16th, after the fight, the winner will be considered pound for pound number one in boxing?
I don't think that's something for me to say. I think that the journalists and the media at large and the fans will have their opinion. But I think that right on the 16th, we have the two best boxers in the sport going at each other. So they can determine that. But going back to what you asked, Eddie, I think the Mexican style, the part of the Mexican style that Golovkin has adapted that the fans really, really like is the fact that of his aggressiveness. It reminds us of some of the fighters of the past, Mexican greats of the past, like Julio César Chávez and some of Olivares' fights and some of the old timers that they used to give us those great entertaining fights.
La respuesta del señor Sánchez es que, mire, eso no es para que yo diga si sí o no, pero eso es para, se lo dejo a la prensa, al público, a todos los fans, que ellos determinen después de la pelea quién es el número uno y si es así. Y sobre la pregunta que le hizo a Eddie sobre el estilo mexicano, mira, los fans lo han dicho, los fans han dicho que él es el estilo mexicano porque les recuerda ese estilo agresivo, como el de Julio César Chávez o Rubén Olivares como los grandes de antaño.
And our next question comes from Rick Mays, The Washington Post.
Hi, I have just a couple quick questions for Abel. The first one, with Gennady, because the fight's so big, because so much went into making this fight, I just wonder if there's anything different about his demeanor, if you can tell he's anticipating or looking forward to this more than previous fights.
Well, absolutely, he's looking very forward to this. I think that he feels that Canelo is the best challenge for him right now. He thinks he's the best boxer out there possible for him. The frustration of having the fights in the past and just talk, and some of the fights that we had to take, I think it's subsided. I think that his anticipation level for this one is like it used to be, like, say, 6-7 fights ago.
And my second question, how would you compare this fight with what we're going to see next week in Vegas with Floyd Mayweather and Conor McGregor as a fight fan?
Well, you know what? I think that we should, in this conference, should concentrate on the two best boxers that are going to fight the 16th. What happens next week is really irrelevant to me. I'd rather just wait for the 16th and put the two best fighters in the ring.
Bravo, bravo.
Thank you.
And our next question comes from Keith Isaac, BoxingScene.com.
Hey, Abel. I was just wondering if you could tell us how important Gennady's jab is in this fight, because obviously he was able to use it very well against Lemieux and then wasn't quite as accurate with his jab against Jacobs for a variety of reasons. So how important is his jab in this fight to winning?
I think all aspects are very important. We had Lemieux in the ring, and Gennady handled him with the jab, but I don't think that's the same. Canelo's not Lemieux. Canelo's a better fighter. Canelo's going to give us some difficulties, but all aspects of it, not only the jab, but the straight right hand is going to be very important. Defense is going to be very important. It's not the easy fight that people are looking at. It's a difficult fight for us, and we're looking forward to the challenge.
Well, what did Jacobs do necessarily to kind of take his jab away a little bit?
First of all, he ran most of the last part of the fight, but I think his size was a little hard to deal with at the beginning, and then by the time he started running, it was easy, difficult to catch up with him. But Jacobs is a very good fighter also, just a different kind of problems that he presents. He's not the fighter that – he doesn't have the boxing ability that Canelo does. Maybe he's got the size and the power and more than Canelo, but Canelo's a better boxer.
How much improvement have you seen in Canelo over the last few years, Abel?
Tremendous improvement. I think that, like I said, Eddie and Chepo have done a fantastic job. I think that when we had him here at 19, 20 years old, he looked like a star, like he could have been a star. He looked like he was progressing, but the fights that they've put him in, the challenges that they've given him have developed him into the star that he is today. I see tremendous improvement.
Also have a question for Eddie. Could you ask him how important it is to kind of neutralize Golovkin's jab if he's going to win this fight?
Eddie, la pregunta es para ti. ¿Qué tan importante es controlar y neutralizar ese jab de Golovkin para ganar la pelea, para salir con la mano en alto?
No, pues es controlar todo ese peleador fuerte que va hacia adelante, que no le importa que le metan 3 o 4 golpes con tarde de dar uno. Es un aporreador 100%. Mucha condición, muy fuerte, siempre está ahí en la pelea, entonces hay que controlar muchas cosas de Golovkin. Para eso estamos en un gran campamento, entonces son muchas las cosas de que tenemos que cuidarnos de Golovkin.
No, it's not just the jab that has to be neutralized, it's a lot of aspects. He's not just, doesn't just have the jab, he's a very aggressive fighter, he's a very strong fighter that comes forward that will take a couple punches to land one. So it's not just the jab. That's why we're doing a tremendous camp and making all the adjustments and training and strategy to have a great fight come September 16th.
Could you also ask Eddie what areas he feels Canelo has improved on in the last couple of years and makes him ready to win this fight?
También la pregunta, Eddie, ¿qué áreas de Canelo han mejorado y por qué es la razón que piensas que va a ganar esta pelea el sábado, 16 de septiembre?
Pues hemos trabajado en todos, estamos trabajando en la defensa, en las combinaciones, en los ataques, estamos trabajando en la condición física, estamos en un campamento como siempre, trabajando todos los aspectos, y creo que Saúl es un peleador más completo, un peleador con más inteligente arriba del ring. Entonces nosotros tenemos la confianza en que el día 16 de septiembre todos nos va a hacer valer para ganar la pelea.
Well, working like we always do, we concentrate on all the aspects, conditioning, counter-punching, attacking, you know, movement. I truly, truly believe that Canelo is a more complete fighter, a more intelligent fighter, and putting it all together on the 16th, that'll let us come out with our hand raised.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
If you have a question, please press star, then one on your touch-tone phone. And our next question is from Albert Perez from Hoy Deportes.
Buenas tardes. Esto es para Eddie. Eddie, ¿consideras que esa es la pelea por el poderío de puños y por las condiciones de Golovkin, que va a ser en la 160, que ha peleado varias veces? ¿Consideras que es la pelea más peligrosa de su carrera? Y segunda, ¿te molesta que Golovkin tenga tanto apoyo de mexicanos que quieran ver a Canelo perder?
The question is, because of his power, because he's in middleweight, because of his style, is this a fight that is very difficult? I mean, that will make Canelo, if he wins, the top? And the second question, does it bother you that Golovkin has a lot of support from the Mexican fans? And will this be the most difficult fight of Canelo's career?
Sí, sin duda es una. Yo creo que es la pelea más peligrosa que ha tenido Saúl en su carrera. Golovkin, hágame decir, usted es un peleador peligroso, un peleador fuerte, un peleador que ya está sentado en esas 160 libras. Sin duda alguna, la pelea más peligrosa que ha tenido Saúl. Y respecto a lo de los mexicanos, pues no, la verdad, siempre en un país tan grande, de cada 10 mexicanos, 9 apoyan a Saúl. Entonces nosotros nos vamos con los 9 que nos apoyan, y los demás pues hacemos como que no son mexicanos.
Yes, absolutely, without a doubt, this is going to be the strongest, the toughest fight of his career at this point, and there's no doubt that's what we're preparing for. And as far as, you know, Golovkin having some Mexican fan support, in a country as big as America, for every one that supports Golovkin, there's 9 that support Canelo. So we'll stick with the 9 that support us, and hey, the other one doesn't matter. It's okay.
Muchas gracias.
And our next question is from Gail Falkenthal from Communities Digital.
Thank you very much. Good morning, gentlemen. You both clearly respect each other very much. That's admirable. I'd like both of you to name something that you like about your opposing trainer, something that you think he does well.
Abel?
I think what I respect most about the Reynosos as a team, Eddie being the head trainer, is the dedication to the sport. I think it's important to have these kind of trainers in the sport, because it just makes our sport greater, and it allows it to grow the way it should. They're perpetuating the knowledge that was taught to them, and it makes us better as a sport.
Eddie, la pregunta es, dino, es admirable el respeto común que se tienen ustedes como entrenadores, obviamente los que van a combatir, pero la pregunta es, quisiera ya saber qué es lo que admiras en este caso de Abel Sánchez, que lo llevas en contra. Abel Sánchez contestó que es admirable la dedicación que han tenido ustedes, tú y Don Chepo, al deporte, y de pasar esa enseñanzas a sus peleadores y mantener el deporte en alto. La pregunta a ti es, ¿qué es lo que admiras de Abel Sánchez como entrenador?
No, pues es una persona dedicada a su trabajo, una persona responsable que le gusta lo que hace, y una persona así pues es de admirar y siempre va a tener el éxito. Entonces se le admira al señor, y más que nada le agradezco que un día me regaló unas mautas.
¿Unas qué? ¿Unas qué?
Me regaló unas manoplas.
Manoplas, okay.
Unas manoplas.
So Eddie's response is, no, it's very, I admire of Abel's dedication and hard work and motivation to be in there, you know, training. And when you do something that you love and passionate about, that's where the success comes from. And I also remember and I'm grateful that back while back he let me have some mitts. So I thank him for that.
Very good. And do both of you agree that Chepo is probably the better singer than either of you?
Yes, I agree.
Oh, my God. So la pregunta es que si los dos pueden estar de acuerdo que Don Chepo es mejor cantante que cualquiera de ustedes dos. Abel dijo que sí, que él está de acuerdo. Eddie.
No, pues claro, para componer y para cantar no tiene llegue a mi padre.
Yes, obviously, absolutely. To compose music and to sing, there's no second. No, nobody comes second to him.
Thank you, muchas gracias, and good luck to both of you.
Thank you.
And our next question comes from Carlos Maciel from Madrid Network.
¿Qué tal, caballeros? Buenas tardes, buenos días. Una pregunta para cada uno. El primero para Eddie Reynoso. Le saluda Carlos Maciel de Show de Madrid. El estilo de Golovkin se acomoda al del Canelo, pero bueno, Saúl lo ha enfrentado a un boxeador con tanto punch, ¿no? ¿Es lo que más les preocupa de Golovkin?
So the question is, Golovkin's style can accommodate into Canelo's style, but he's never faced somebody as strong of a puncher. Is that what worries you most about Golovkin, his power?
Sí, Golovkin tiene un estilo que se le acomoda a cualquier peleador para dar buenas peleas. Un peleador que va al frente siempre y está buscando la pelea, se acomoda a cualquier estilo. Entonces, yo creo que ese día se van a acoplar los estilos. Y en cuanto a la pegada de Golovkin, pues claro, es lo que más tenemos que cuidar. Un peleador, como te digo, fuerte, agresivo, que tiene una gran condición física. Entonces hay que tener mucho cuidado en todo eso. Pero la pegada sí es algo que hay que tenerle respeto.
Yes, you know, Golovkin has a style that is pleasing. It makes fights pleasing and can easily be adapted to as well. And I think that we will see September 16th how it'll adapt to Canelo's style and provide a great fight. And as far as the power, yes, absolutely, that is something we have to be wary of. We respect his power. We know what his power is, and we have to be wary of that.
Si me permiten una pregunta más para Eddie Reynoso antes de pasar con Abel Sánchez, le preguntaría, ¿qué han hecho diferente? Comentabas que es la pelea más importante, más peligrosa para Canelo Álvarez. ¿Qué han hecho diferente en esta preparación para enfrentar el combate?
The question against Eddie is, it's been mentioned that it's the most dangerous fight to date for Canelo Álvarez, and what have you done different in camp? What has been done different to face him?
No, pues lo mismo, siempre trabajar en todos los aspectos, llegar bien preparado físicamente, mentalmente, artísticamente. Los sparring son los que cambian, hay que estarlos rotando. Entonces, ahorita que están de moda las rotaciones ahí en México, ¿verdad? Entonces, lo mismo, con disciplina, con determinación, enfrentar un compromiso. Sabemos la clase de peleador que tenemos y sacarle todo el jugo, sacarle todas las cualidades que tiene para que ese día nos levanten la mano.
No, the same thing we always do. Look, we always work on conditioning, we always work on strength, and we always work on the strategy. That's what's gotten us to where we are today. You know, we're going to continue doing that, working hard. We know what we have in front. And the only thing that changes is the sparring partners, depending on what style, you know. And we're rotating them often, just like it's very popular in Mexico right now, the rotations. And that's what we're doing, just getting ready, preparing properly, so that our hand will be raised come September 16th.
Ahora la pregunta para el señor Abel Sánchez, de parte de Carlos Macé, del Show del Mandril. ¿Es cierto que en la pelea contra Daniel Jacobs planearon una estrategia de falsa vulnerabilidad, o sea, no mostrarse tan avasallador para que Golden Boy Promotions tomara la pelea? ¿Qué hay de cierto en eso?
¿Ya translated, Robert?
Yeah, the question is it true that for the Daniel Jacobs, you showed the strategy was to show a false vulnerability so that Golden Boy Promotions can then say, look, he's vulnerable, let's go ahead and make the fight.
Absolutely not. You never take a chance on losing a fight, and by doing something ridiculous like that, we take a chance of the judges seeing it the other way. Our fight against Canelo was made because Canelo felt that he was ready, Oscar felt that he was ready, and the Reynoso felt that he was ready. But there was no intent on our part, on mine or Golovkin's part or the team's part, to look bad. We did what we needed to do against Jacobs to win. Jacobs was a difficult opponent, but by no means did we slack off. We wanted this fight, but we wanted this fight at our best.
No, de ninguna manera, vamos a arriesgarnos a perder o que los jueces piensen y vean que no fue de nuestra favor la pelea. No, Jacobs fue un peleador difícil, complicado un poquito, pero no de ninguna manera fue una estrategia ni de Golovkin, ni de mi parte, ni del equipo. La pelea se hizo ahora con Canelo porque Canelo la quiso, Oscar la quiso, sentían los Reynosos la querían. Y sentían que en ese momento ya era momento de hacer la pelea.
Gracias. Buenas tardes.
Gracias.
And our next question is from Rigo Cervantes, ESPN Digital.
Hola de nuevo a los dos. Y les voy a hacer otra pregunta al respecto de que no todos los títulos estarán en juego. ¿Es eso cierto? Es decir, no todos los títulos de Triple G, que tiene cuatro coronas, ¿estarán en disputa el día del 16 de septiembre?
The question is to both camps. Not all the titles are on the line. You know, Triple G has the four titles. Are they all on the line or are they not? Abel?
For us, for Golovkin, he's very proud of the four belts that he holds right now. He will be risking them on that night. Canelo and Golden Boy choose to fight for, that's up to them. But I respect whatever it is that they choose to do. That's their option and their choice.
Por Golovkin, él está muy orgulloso de los cuatro títulos que mantiene, y los cuatro van a estar en juego el día de la pelea. Sobre Canelo y Golden Boy y su equipo, de los cuales pelearán o algo, esa es decisión de ellos y yo respeto la decisión de ellos. Eddie.
Sí, yo creo que esto ya está muy trillado, ya Golden Boy mandó el comunicado pertinente, entonces nosotros lo que nos queda es estar listo para la pelea, trabajar fuerte y ganar a como dé lugar.
Look, this has already been something that's already been cleared and sent out. Golden Boy sent out the alert. To us, now the only thing that's left is train, prepare, get ready, and win the fight. Next question.
And our next question is from Terrell Van from Fight U 360.
This question is for Abel. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so since there's it's still not confirmed whether Canelo was fighting for that WBC title or not, can you explain the drug testing situation? Is there VADA drug testing? Also, will both fighters be taking part in the IBF day of weigh-in?
Robert?
Yeah, I could answer that. Look, there is VADA testing. VADA testing is not put in just only from an organization. There is VADA testing. Both are fighting, regardless if one's fighting for the belt or not. Both fighters have been tested and are still being tested. And as far as the IBF second day weigh-in, yes, they're fighting for the IBF title, and that's the rule of the IBF.
Okay, and final question. Can somebody, you know, anybody touch on the undercard? Like, is the undercard finalized and set? Because so far we only see Diego De La Hoya, Antonio Orozco, Ryan Martin. Is there anything else to be expected?
Of course. I mean, when you have a great event, a great main event, obviously there's going to be some great appetizers before that. But that'll be coming out soon, very soon, promise.
Okay, thank you.
And our next question is from John Gatlin from NewYorkFights.com.
Thank you very much. Abel, question for you. You faced Andre Roser, who trained Curtis Stevens when Golovkin faced him. And, of course, I mean, he was a trainer for for Daniel Jacobs. They had an all-star team, Virgil Hunter, Andre Ward, everybody else. Chris Algieri cooking for him. Yet you hold Canelo in higher regard than Daniel Jacobs, based on what you were saying earlier, because recently you were quoted as saying that Canelo was basically a slapper, that he wasn't really a hard puncher, and that if Gennady does what he's supposed to do, which you expect him to do, that the fight's easy. So have you reconsidered that based on some things that you've seen recently?
No, absolutely not. What I'm saying is that Canelo is the next one in line, and Canelo, when he gets in a hurry, tends to slap. If you go back to the quote that I did, that I said, when he gets in a hurry, he tends to slap. But Canelo's the most important fight and the most difficult fight in front of us right now. Why? Because he's in front of us right now. He's on the 16th. If we were fighting Jacobs, I would have said the same thing about Jacobs. So it's Canelo right now, and Canelo is the most difficult to this point because he is next.
Do you think that based on, you know, the opponents that Gennady's faced up to this point in his career, that Canelo is a puncher with more variety, with more suddenness, with more commitment? He was obviously upset with the notion that he was ducking Golovkin. And the improvement that you've seen over, is this the reason why you consider him the most prominent threat that Golovkin's ever faced?
I think Canelo is the best counterpuncher they will have faced to date. He may not be the puncher that Curtis is with one shot, or Lemieux, let's just say, but he's a heck of a better boxer than both of those guys. And not only that, he's directly in front of us right now. So he's the most difficult guy. We don't get past him. Doesn't matter what we did against the rest.
Okay. And a question for Eddie Reynoso. Canelo was obviously upset with the notion that he wasn't ready for Golovkin last year. He seemed to scoff at the notion that, you know, he was somehow avoiding Golovkin and everything else. With that being said, the year that's passed and that's ensued, are you seeing a fighter that's more determined to come out here and prove definitively that he can beat Golovkin and is actually looking for a knockout?
Eddie, Canelo es obvio que estaba, que le dio coraje, que se enojó cuando la noción de que tal vez le tenía miedo a Golovkin y rehuyó la pelea y no le quería pelear. ¿Tú crees que eso es un extra para motivarlo, para llegar y comprobar que no le tenía miedo, que no le rehuyó y hasta buscar un knockout para ganar claramente?
No, la verdad, esto es un negocio y las peleas grandes duran en tiempo en hacerse. Esta es una pelea de las más grandes, de las más esperadas en los últimos años. Entonces, rehuirle a nadie. Si entramos al boxeo y él desde que tiene 13 años está subiéndose a un ring, él nunca ha demostrado miedo a nadie. Un peleador que se sube a exponer la vida, la verdad, pues no le teme nada.
One of the best fights.
Entonces,
Hello?
And
this is a fight that, look, it can't be made overnight.
Este es su tiempo y el ingrediente que tiene esta pelea para ganar y motivar a Canelo es como la tuvo desde que empezó el boxeo. Él siempre ha trabajado fuerte y para esta pelea no es la excepción.
And the ingredient that he has that motivates him is what he's had since day one. He's always wanted to be go down to history as one of the biggest and best fighters in history. So he will continue to work hard. He will continue to go on. And like I said, these fights aren't made overnight. It took a little bit of time, but we're here now.
And our next question is from Jules Philippe August from Heavy Bag Boxing.
Yes, hi. First and foremost, Eddie and Abel, thank you so much for taking the time to speak with us.
Hello?
I greatly appreciate it. Yes, hi. Can you hear me?
I can hear
Hello?
You.
My deepest apologies. First and foremost, I want to thank both you guys for taking the time to speak with us today, Eddie and Abel. So greatly appreciate it. This question, first and foremost, is going to go to Abel. One of the things that I noticed in the Canelo fight when he fought Julio Cesar Chavez Jr.
Yeah.
was that he allowed himself to be pushed back, and he took a lot of his shots. Do you think that is going to be an advantage for Triple G? Do you think that he'll be able to do a lot more damage on Canelo if he has Canelo on the ropes?
Well, let me just say this. Watching that fight, to me, wasn't indicative of what Canelo would be doing against Golovkin. Sometimes challenges to fighters at this level, there needs to be a challenge.
We still here.
There needs to be that mental challenge. And I think that Canelo is going to be well prepared, and he's going to be ready to do everything he needs to do to not allow Golovkin to push him around. But then that's our job to make sure that that does happen. So if that's the case, we're going to be treated to a great fight.
Okay, perfect. And, Eddie, this question is actually for you. In terms of Canelo in this fight, you know, one of the things that we know about Mexico is has a very, very good, you know, history of great fighters. Salvador Sanchez recently, the great Marquez retired, Morales and Barrera. If Canelo is able to get a win over over Canelo, where would you rank Canelo in terms of those illustrious those illustrious fighters? I'm sorry, Golovkin, excuse me.
Eddie, la pregunta es para ti. ¿Qué tan importante? ¿Dónde pondrían? ¿Dónde crees que quedaría Canelo de salir victorioso contra un peleador como Golovkin entre los grandes de la historia, tal como Márquez, Barrera, Morales? ¿Cómo quedaría Canelo?
So, Eddie dropped off. We're having him call back in.
I mean, I'll wait till Eddie gets back for him to completely answer, but I think, obviously, at a fighter of this nature, of Canelo beating the Golovkin, you know, it's automatic that, obviously, he'll go down as... And it's not over. He's still young. There's still a lot more fights for him. But it would definitely go on against in the record books as one of the biggest victories in boxing for Mexico. Do you have a question for Abel right now that he's on that we can go to?
We have no further questions.
Okay, then I can invite Abel. Abel, do you want to make some closing comments?
Yes. Thank you, Robert. Thank you to the media that posed all the questions. Thank you to everybody listening. We're looking forward, again, to a great fight on the 16th. I know that Eddie and Chip are going to have Canelo as ready as he can be. Hopefully we get the kind of response that this fight deserves. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Abel. Thank you very much. Tom, any closing comments?
No, I just, you know, the expectations of this fight is tremendous. I know Abel wasn't as outspoken as far as the one question, you know, if he thinks the winner of this fight is the best fighter in the sport. I truly believe when you have two warriors of this caliber, not only... you know, of their fighting style and ring IQ and the fighting caliber, but their marketability that both guys bring to the ring. I think the winner clearly would be the best fighter in the sport of boxing, and not only the fighters, but also I think the trainer that wins this fight, the winning trainer, you know, would definitely be there for trainer of the year. So I think this promotion definitely has a lot riding on it, not only for the fighters and the trainers, but, you know, just the event itself has taken on a life of its own. So we appreciate everyone for being on the call. Thanks. Thanks, Robert.
And Eddie's online.
We're here. We don't hear anything.
Robert, I can hear you.
Okay, now, yes.
Robert,
Eddie, ¿tiene comentarios para cerrar la llamada?
Sí, muchísimas gracias a todos los que apoyan esta gran pelea. Fue un placer hablar con ustedes y pues saludo también a Abel y saludos a todos los que estuvieron aquí presentes. Y nos vemos el 16.
Thank you very much for joining us in this conference call. And we will be seeing you guys on September 16th. Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. This concludes today's conference. Thank you for participating. You may now disconnect.